Hi everyone, my name is Alonso and today I have a special guest for my first interview. She's an American actress and she's best known for her role as the violinist Callisto in Xena Warrior Princess.
You'd like to kill me? Wish you could.
But she participated in several movies and TV shows like Law and Order.
He was talking to a woman. Helga was gone. Who else would be in his apartment at that hour?
Melrose Place.
I'm Shelley. Shelley Hansen. Your sister-in-law. Jess's wife. Well, Jess's ex-wife. Is he here?
Touched by an Angel.
I'm so happy I've got legs to dance.
Oh, blessed Lord, give me patience and give this child some rhythm.
Jess, look at this. I got 10 fingers and 10 little fingernails.
Is it true if one breaks off, another one will just grow right back?
The fingernails, yes. The fingers, no. You've got to calm down, Cherub Child. There's nothing worse than an angel that goes off half-cocked.
Cold Heart.
Linda, honey, you have a really hard time letting things go. Okay, let's say that he has another woman.
CSI.
He told me he was married. It wasn't a problem for me. He said they made better friends than lovers and that she was a good mother. That's about it.
Was he violent?
Ray? No, he was nothing like that.
But she's also a yoga instructor.
Exhale, bring your forehead down to the ground. Bring your hands back.
Press into the hands and press yourself back to seated position. And that is Cobra.
She's an intuitive counselor and astrologer.
What I'm going to be talking about today is the sign of Aries. Fiery, fast, initiator, cardinal sign. It is the element of fire. It's the first sign in the zodiac. It is incredibly passionate. It is ruled by Mars.
Well, she has many skills. So, ladies and gentlemen, the one and only Hudson Light.
Sweet dreams are made of these. Who am I to disagree?
Hello, Hudson. How you doing?
I'm well. How are you?
I'm excellent. Really excellent. And happy to interview you.
Thank you.
Before we started, I have to say a few words, right? First, thank you so much for agreeing to give me this interview. It's a great pleasure. And when I was deeply young, in my humble life, and I watched you on TV, I never thought that one day, I would have a face-to-face conversation with you. So it's a dream come true. Thank you so much for being part of my childhood and make me happy. And thank you so much for being who you are, because I really admire you. Well, I love you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, let's get to the questions before I start crying.
Okay, good idea.
The first question is, Callisto became very famous on a show. If at the time you had won a show of your own like Lucy, what do you think it would be like?
Well, they did throw around the idea of giving Callisto her own show, I think with, what is his name? I can't remember. The guy up from, I can't remember his name and it's terribly embarrassing. Anyways, they did talk about another show and me being a pirate, being on a pirate ship. And they asked me what I thought about it. Rob Tappert asked me what I thought about it. And I was like, yeah, it sounds interesting, I guess. But if you play, I didn't understand how you would take the character Callisto, because she's a bad guy, and how you would, you can't have a bad guy in a show and doing awful things every day. Like that's can't be a protagonist. Although now that's totally true. They do have the bad guys as being the protagonist, which can be really fascinating. What do I think the show would have been like? I can't even answer that. I have no idea, because it's so in fantasy for me. I think people who have their own shows work really hard. They work really, really hard. It's very exhausting. It's a very hard thing to be the main star in a TV show. It's really challenging. So I have a lot of respect for people who have that fortitude to do that. Mm-hmm. But I couldn't tell you what it would be like, especially back then. I have no idea.
Okay. When you played Callisto, was it difficult for you to focus on yoga to keep your peace and calm?
So, I did. When I started doing Callisto, I was not doing yoga, and I was in a very, very rough place emotionally in my life. Very, very rough place. And I did not meditate at that time or do yoga. I don't think I meditated. I can't remember. And I did a little bit of yoga, but not... that's not true. I did yoga. I did do yoga. And I'm sure it helped somewhat. But I did classes in LA, and then when I went to New Zealand, I did maybe a couple classes, but not ongoing. So no, it didn't help me because I didn't do it enough. But I can tell you what helped me a lot during that time that was really stressful for me was to be out in the New Zealand nature. Their nature is just so absolutely beautiful that some days we'd be in a farm. And when I say farm, it was big hills, like really beautiful. Mm-hmm. And the air is just so pure because there's not that many people in New Zealand. So it's just really clean. And I would think, I'd be in my little trailer and I'd have my incense going, and I would think, this has to be the best job in the world. Like, where else could you actually look out your window and see a farm in nature? Mm-hmm. It makes me always happy. So, yes. And doing meditation and yoga now, I think has profoundly changed my life. But it has to be consistent. It can't be like, it's really important that I do my practice every day to get full benefit.
Okay. In a recent interview for Make Miracles Happen, you said that maybe you'll be acting again one day. Do you still intend to or not?
I don't know. I'm not interested. I'm not going after it. I have no interest in trying to get an agent and a manager and a TV show. I don't have interest in it. But I think it would be... I think it would always be kind of silly to say no to everything. I mean, there's some things I could say no to, but that, I don't have a great love of it. Sometimes I miss theater on stage. Mm-hmm. I like theater and being interactive with people. But you never know. But I love not being. I love not being. I really love to be in the simple world and not important.
All right. Your last participation at a convention was in 2016 in Adelaide. Will you be going to future conventions when the world gets back to normal? Or have you indeed your stage appearances?
I can't answer that either. I don't know. I don't know what... I don't have a great desire to do it. I don't. Mm-hmm. I don't feel like that's the best use of my being to, it was super fun when I did do conventions, super fun. But now I don't think that would be as interesting to me anymore. It's not so, like, I understand you want to ask questions about my acting world and my past because it affected your life directly. And that was really, and I have a lot of compassion for that. But because I'm a separate being, and that was over 20 years ago for me, although it's an honor to be a part of other people's kids' lives. It is. It's an honor. It's not my experience. So it's a very strange experience. Like, you feel like you know me somewhat because I sat in your living room. And that's like something very intimate, right? Mm-hmm. But I've never seen you. Do you see what I mean? Mm-hmm. It's a very weird life to be an actor. Because people really get to know what you're like, how you move, how you speak, how you think. And they like it or they don't like it. But it's... you don't get to have that same experience with the people, right? So when I'm done, when I would act on Xena and they would film me, it's done. It's done for me. Like, I don't go back and watch all my shows. I don't. Some actors love that. But me, after they're like, okay, and it's a take. Is there hair in the gate? No, we're good. Okay, moving on. It's just moving on. So I have the awareness that people are really interested in the fact that they know me from 25 years ago. I respect that. And that part of my life 25 years ago is done. Like, I've finished it. And so what I'm interested in now is like finding who I am, what's my voice, what's my gift to humanity that I can give other people. And I do think acting is a gift to give people, because stories, I love stories. I absolutely love stories. I love good characters that can play really good, tell the story in a way that's really interesting. But for me now, and to try to describe it to somebody else who's had such a different experience, so you have a different experience of just watching me, but you don't know as a human being what I went through while I was acting, while I was on set, while I was trying to get jobs. Like, nobody knows those sides. They just know what they see on the TV set. So for me, it's not... acting was fulfilling for times. There was moments I really loved acting, but it's not, it doesn't, I'm not called to do it. I don't, if I was, no problem. If I was, I'd be like, I have to act. I don't feel like I have to act. I feel like I would like, my life's going to be gone like this, right? I'm alive, I'll be, I mean, it's all of us. It's quick. What can I do that feels good within myself? And I think one of the things that makes me feel good in myself is to try to be of service to other people in some way. In some way. And no longer is it in the idea of wanting to put a bunch of lipstick on and makeup on and play that anymore. That was great when I did it, but that's not where my heart is.
About yoga. For depressed and anxious people, does yoga bring tranquility to help them overcome?
Yes, yoga can. Yeah. I mean, yoga is not the only modality, of course, but this is the path that I took. So when I started taking yoga, I was not calm at all. And nor, it took me a long time to even have the calm that I have right now. But yoga immediately, I can say, it immediately, it's got to be consistent. But when I started doing yoga in New York City, I was 23. And I immediately felt a peace I never had. So it's not just gymnastics. There's something profound about how you open your meridians in your whole body, your breath. The whole practice is geared to unwinding your nervous system. And unwinding your nervous system sounds like nothing until you start doing it. You must have your own experience doing it. Having someone talk about it doesn't mean anything. But when you start doing it yourself and you realize what peace it gives you, then you may want it more. Otherwise, it's just a person telling a story.
Wow, this is incredible. Can you talk about your new projects? I'm very curious to find out more about it.
Today is the 16th of November. So by the time we may share this, it may no longer be the 16th of November. We're doing an online yoga retreat the 19th through the 21st of November. So it's this coming Friday. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And then we're doing something else for the holidays, which I thought would be really great because holidays are tricky for people. So in the States, we celebrate something called Thanksgiving, which is a beautiful idea in theory to give thanks. And I celebrate it when I'm in Europe, even with my European friends, we still celebrate Thanksgiving. But what can happen? And in America, in the United States of America, Thanksgiving is the biggest holiday of all of the holidays. So, and the idea of doing it in a way that could be really loving. But the thing is, sorry, I'm jumping all over the place. I think what I mean to say is holidays can be incredibly stressful. Whether you have really strong families that you love, but you go to and you feel crazy around your families. I certainly did. I felt crazy around my families. And I could feel really alone when I was with my family too. And I would feel ungrounded. And especially if I was flying somewhere and isolated. And there's so many people that also spend time by themselves, all alone. So what I've decided to do this year is to have like an hour yoga class and one half an hour guided meditation so people can really land in their body. But they can feel the connection and feel loved and feel seen and appreciated. But being in your body is incredibly important when there's a lot going on. And we're talking about, with my partner, we're talking about, my business partner, we're talking about doing one for Christmas Eve as well and Christmas. And we only want to do it an hour and a half so people can still spend the time with their family. And I think we're charging $48 for each one. But if people don't have the money, it's not a problem. If they don't have the money and they still want to connect, you can still connect. Yeah. You just contact Jacob and you say, I don't have the funds right now. And the reason I really want to do this is because I have gone to dance classes myself during the holidays, and having your own connection to your own family, even if it's online, can feel really warm and loving when you might feel alone. And I just never want people to feel alone. In fact, I always get in trouble even while I'm staying here during the coronavirus time, because I'll invite a whole bunch of people to Thanksgiving and my friends are like, hey, like, why are you inviting all these people? You have to talk to us. But it never occurs to me, because I don't want people to be alone. I think holidays should be for sharing love and feeling connected and being fed and not feeling isolated and not cared for. And there's too many of us in the world that don't feel cared for.
Okay. What has changed from the old Hudson? The Hudson of now.
What's changed from the old Hudson to the Hudson of now? You mean the old Hudson like 20 years ago?
Yeah.
20 years ago. Whew, it's a good question. I think I had a lot of self-hatred, a lot of judgment, very critical of myself, and a lot of anger, a lot of pain, unprocessed pain, and a lot of anger, and deep sadness underneath that, deep sadness. I think what's changed in me now is so subtle. It's so subtle that it's hard to put into words, and it keeps changing. It doesn't mean that like I'm fixed or I'm staying like this forever. I think we always grow. We're constantly growing. You're going to constantly grow, my dear friend. It's never going to stop until you pass, until the body dies. And even then we keep going. We keep going. This, after this goes, we still keep going. So I would say, I'd say having a spiritual teacher in my life who is a guru to me, and guru, what guru means, that word means, is it means the light bringer, the one that dispels the darkness, the one that dispels ignorance. So when you're in a great deal of pain and suffering, you're in, it can be called in ignorance, not because you're dumb. It's because you can't see clearly. And it's not that I can see so clearly now either. I have a long way to go, but I can see more clearly than I could back then because the pain was so bad. And I have a lot of empathy for people who struggle with emotional pain and can't see a way out of it, because I experienced that a lot. And my path is different from other people's path, but if I can be even a touchstone which can help people, which is why I offer yoga and meditation and yoga retreats and make bracelets and do astrological readings, like whatever my gifts are, they're all geared towards trying to be of service in some way. And that being of service in some way, don't kid yourself. It's super selfish. When you're of service to other people, you have a love for yourself that gets to start to blossom, because we're all connected. So when I'm connecting to other people in service, I'm being of service to myself as well. And you get to like yourself again. When we're very selfish about getting, it's never enough. There's never enough things that are going to make us whole, ever. It's always going to be another desire, another person, another job, another something. It doesn't end. So how do you find peace and being present in the now and acceptance of what's going on right now without trying to change it? It's these things are really curious to me. They're very important to me. And I think I learned this through my guru. I'm learning. I haven't learned it. I'm learning. So meditation, Kriya meditation, has profoundly changed me. It's called Kriya Yoga Meditation. I've done 5 Vipassana meditation retreats. Those have been powerful. I have friends that have loved me through really hard times. Human beings, connecting to human beings, like we're so, don't take your friendship of anyone for granted, because it's, we're so lucky to have friends in our life. It's seeing things differently.
Okay. How can people contact you to get information about your current work?
People can, there's a website that Renee made, and that she upkeeps, and same with Jacob. Jacob also helps on it. And it's just my name. It's Hudson Like, so Hudson. My last name is Leick.com. And it will say all the things that we're offering at the moment.
All right. This is my last question. Actually, it's not a question. It's a small request. Can you send a message to your Brazilian fans?
Gosh, I meant to look up Brazil before we did this, and I completely forgot, because I don't know a lot about Brazil. I know that there's a lot of amethyst crystals in Brazil, like amazing mines of amethyst crystal, which I think are fascinating, and crystal mines in Brazil. And of course, I know like the Brazilian people are they're considered very beautiful and very sexy, and they have crazy bathing suits or barely bathing suits. But really, I'm so uneducated about the Brazilian people. And actually, I'm going to look you guys up. I'm going to look up Brazil after we get off, because I do want to know. So I can't say something to the culture because I don't know enough about it at all. But I can say to anybody who's watched the show in the past that I've done, especially Zena, thank you so much for watching. And I'm really, I feel really, I incredibly grateful to be a part of something that has been of support to so many people. And I loved playing my character. I loved my character. I'm really grateful for that character. I loved her so much. It couldn't have been a better character for me to get to interact with. The whole storyline, the whole thing. So what would I say to them? I would say to the Brazilian people, if you like that show and you're curious about yourself, like, love yourself, figure out how to really, not in some egotistical vain way, but in some beautiful way, connect to nature, connect to yourself, connect to other people, be kind to yourself and be kind to other people and enjoy life. I think the Brazilian people, this is my guess, but have a very amazing passion, maybe for food, maybe for life. Be present with that. Be present, and because it's just moments. We all have just moments. That's all we have. So don't wait for the next one. Don't dream of the next one. Only enjoy each moment. Savor each moment.
Wow. That was awesome. Really, really beautiful. Thank you for that. Okay, thank you so much again for this incredible interview. I really appreciated every single moment with you. It was amazing. Thank you.
Okay, Bobby. So thank you so much for this, and I wish you so much success.
Thank you. Okay. Thank you so much. Okay, thank you guys. Thank you so much. Bye.
Bye guys. Bye.
I love you.
Bye, Alonso.
Bye, Hudson.
I love you. Bye. Bye.